Friday Show, coming to you live from the tips of the Keys to the top of Palm Beach County and parts further out west, and of course all of our internet listenership all over the Northeast. It's a beautiful day in Miami. It's a beautiful day now in our studio because we have Susanna Vega here and our talk. Welcome.
Good morning, Anthony. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic.
Great. Well, I have to tell you, again, sunshine in our studio. I have an amazing lady who has really raised the bar when it comes to Latin American art, contemporary art, especially from her beautiful country, Mexico. She's been really doing so many projects and a pioneer and a visionary in some of the affairs that she has done on her own. And with that said, Nina Torres, welcome to our talk.
Thank you. Good morning. It's a pleasure.
It's great to see you, Nina. I was actually at your event on Thursday evening. I met the consul of Mexico, and you had about 30 artists showing some beautiful paintings. And I have to tell you, I really commend you because you're always, you know, really servicing the art community with your beautiful receptions and vernissages. And you don't charge, at least for those vernissages. I know the art fair that you do in Basel, you do, and we'll talk about that. But what made you come to Miami?
Well, Miami is like my second house. When I was living in New York for 10 years, we came to spend the winters, and I fell in love with Miami, especially for the weather, for the people, the community, my people. I am from Mexico, and I feel really at home. Additional, Miami was racing in art. After 20 years in the arts, I decided that Miami, it is the right place to open my gallery.
And now that you've had your gallery since 2010, I believe, you opened up your first gallery, which was in Wynwood, and now you've actually have done something which a lot of people are following, which is opening up your art gallery in the Arts and Entertainment District there in North Bayshore Drive, waterfront, because the bay is right in front, a very large gallery. What's that, like 10,000 square feet?
10,000 square feet, and I really use 8,000 as a gallery. We have a large area for storage and for other areas, but 8,000, yes.
And basically, you really are committed passionately to show contemporary works from Latin American artists and, of course, your country as well, or a little bit of everything?
Actually, I work with more than 3,000 international artists from all over the world. Okay. The exhibition that I have right now, it is only from Mexico. The name is Mexican Visions, because in September is the Independence Month of Mexico, and we are celebrating that these artists, they needed an opportunity to go international. And we decided to invite in this month and celebrate with Mexican artists, with Mexican art, and give them the opportunity. And I can tell you, well, you saw that was a great success. We have almost 600 people who attended the opening.
Yes, I was there. I ended up going a little later because I went to see my dear friend Mimi Ferrer at the Coral Gables Museum of Art, which was amazing that night also. So I made it a point to go there early and then come to you. And yes, I was very pleasantly surprised that you still at 9:30 had the place buzzing, and I got to meet the consul of Mexico. And I mean, your country is so colorful.
Yeah.
I mean, I've been to Mexico about 8 times, and it's one of my favorite places. You can't get more vibrant colors. I think the palette of an artist comes from Mexico, from the sand to the sea to everything. It's just amazing.
Absolutely. And Mexico is, remember that we have more than 30 centuries of art.
Mm-hmm.
And the biggest artists from Mexico, the big muralists, Diego Rivera, Siqueiros, Orozco, and it's a really great school at La Esmeralda, San Carlos, and many of the artists who really wants to get a great knowledge, they come from all over the world, and because they know that the community of art in Mexico is very big. There are a lot of collectors, and they love to collect Mexican art, and artists from all over the world that assist very regular to the auctions for the Latin American art in New York for Christie's, Sotheby's, and they are traveling all over the world collecting art. It's a big, big community for art.
Now, you yourself have curated and overseen exhibitions, hundreds of exhibitions through England, Mexico, Belgium, the Netherlands, and France. And now here you have committed, which we're very proud to have you, in Miami, in the Wynwood area at one moment, and now you're into the Arts and Entertainment District with Nina Torres Gallery. Now, there's something else that I thought was pretty amazing, and you're a one-woman show, so I know to do anything, small, it takes so much process, so much energy, and, you know, you're doing it for the second time in a row, which means the first time was successful, and that's Art Basel, the Miami River Art Fair.
Yes, that's true. I was working in this project for more than 3 years. As I mentioned before, when I was spending the winters here in Miami, I was living in downtown, and when I walked through the Miami River, I was amazed because I found that place, the Miami Convention Center inside the Jensen Knight, and I saw the place, and I knew that that was a place not for one exhibition, but for a big, big show. And thinking that when Art Basel arrived to Miami, the eyes of the world are in Miami, I was thinking, why not have one art show with international artists in one new location in the heart of the financial area of Miami, which there is not really a big presence of art. Plus, on the banks of the river, I have monumental sculptures, and this make a very rich show. Additional, that this place is a beautiful place, is in the heart of downtown.
I think it's fabulous.
Uh-huh. And many people mentioned, this is the new face of Miami. Now, I decided to bring the art to downtown Brickell, plus to the Miami River Art Fair that many people don't pay attention, only the Biscayne Bay, and now the Miami River and the art, now we're on the map.
I think it's great. It's fabulous. And, you know, to do this, taking it from a thought 3 years ago and then creating, developing, launching, and implementing, it's a lot of energy. And, you know, you always spend thousands and thousands, hundreds of thousands probably in your case, and to see, will it work? Will the people buy the tickets? Will it come in? Will I get the right press? Well, I certainly know you get the right press because I certainly see a lot of the great articles. Also, you also devote yourself to your artists because I see you advertising it everywhere. So you certainly have that commitment to your artists, which is fabulous. I have to tell you, I plan to work with you, hopefully, with the Miami River Art Fair. I think it is excellent. But I also want to let my public know, you are also, Nina Torres, you're also part of the monumental statues in Bayfront Park.
Absolutely. Yes.
So all those big statues that you see, the Poteros, the all of those are, is that, which ones are
no,
you?
No, this a sculpture that are not from the gallery. I place for 5 months a monumental sculptures in front of the bay,
okay,
where is
okay.
The Miami art exhibition. And now I just moved. Because now it's going to start a new exhibition in the Jensen Knight Center at the front of the Jens and on the back. We are going to start installing right now 12 monumental sculptures that they are going to be there permanently till the Miami River Art Fair in our second edition.
Now, out of those monuments, what in height, in volume, are some of the artists, can we get a clue?
Yes.
In both?
Now, I have 9 sculptures that they are going to install in the next week from a Cuban artist, Rafael Consuegra. Mm-hmm. I am waiting to arrive 5 monumental sculptures from Greece.
Oh, wow.
Christina Saradopoulos, amazing sculptures. I am waiting sculptures from Spain, and I am waiting for a project from Mexico also.
Awesome.
And all these they are going to display there, because inside, the James L. Knight, all the common areas, they are in displaying more than 100 artwork from artists from the roster of the Nina Torres Fine Art, and is displaying, and we have once a month, we have a guide visit, and is going to be open for the next art days, the September 20, 21st, and 22nd, and is permanent exhibition, and the most important is that this area is a gallery open 24/7, because this big complex is open to the public every day and night.
So in the James Knight Center, you're going to have monumental sculptures in the next week and following through as a pre-kickoff launching to your Miami River Art Fair.
Correct.
And so with that said, your art fair, the Miami River Art Fair, which is a waterfront art gallery with beautiful international artists. How many galleries do you plan to show this year in your Miami River?
Well, the Miami River has 40 booths, which they are totally fully booked.
Oh, wow.
I can mention that the galleries come from Monaco, France, Mexico,
International.
Korea.
Now, Nina Torres, you're at 1800 North Bayshore Drive. Your company number is 305-395-3599. If our audience wanted to see more about the Great Art Basel event that you're doing and all the other wonderful vernissages, which I really highly recommend it to my fans, go see this lady. She's committed to art. She really brings in some beautiful. So give your website one more time.
www.ninatorresfineart.com.
Well, thank you, Nina, for coming on our show.